Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fine. So first of all students, congratulations to those who are getting more than 35 in their first term examinations. And soon we are having our half yearly. So now we should start preparing for our half yearly exams. So we will continue from where we have left. Today we are starting your new chapter, chapter number 4, that is fractions. So what is fraction? Fraction is a number which represents a part of whole. The whole may be a single object or a group of objects. Okay? So basically fraction represent a part of a whole. Here I have drawn two circles. Okay? This is known as your whole circle, or you can say one whole. And here I have divided this circle into two equal parts. Okay, so how many parts now the circle is having? Two parts. And how many parts I have shaded? One. So this 1 by 2 become your fraction. That's why we are saying that the fraction represent a part of a whole. So here I have written some fractions, that is your 2 by 3, 5 by 7, 3 by 2, 5 whole 2 by 6, 1 by 4, etc. Okay, next we are having your denominators and numerators of our fractions. So I have taken an example over here, that is 2 by 3. Now this line is known as your line of division. Okay, this one line. So the number below the division line is known as your denominator, and the number above the divisible line is known as your numerator. Now what is your numerator? Numerator means how many parts are taken. Okay, numerator means you have, how many parts you have taken, whether you have shaded them or you have not shaded them, it's just how many parts you are taken. And denominator is how many equal parts a whole is divided, and denominator means how many equal parts the whole is divided. So one example is here, I have drawn a circle over here and I have divided this circle into three equal parts. Okay. So now I told you to write the fraction of this circle. As I told you, a fraction contains two parts, a numerator and a denominator. So what is your denominator? That how many parts a whole is having. So I have divided the whole into how many parts? 1, 2, 3. 3 equal parts I have divided. So 3 becomes your denominator. And how many parts I have taken? 1, 2. So 2 become your numerator. You will read the fraction as 2 by 3 or 2 third. Same with this one. Here I have drawn a rectangle and I have divided it into 7 equal parts. So your denominator will be 7 and your numerator will be 3. And you will read the fraction as 3 by 7 or 3 seventh. Now next is your types of fractions. First is your like fractions. Fractions that have same denominators are called like fractions. So if a fraction have same denominator, they are said to be like fractions. For example, 1 upon 5, 2 upon 5, 3 upon 5 and 4 upon 5 and etc. Here you can see all of them having 5 as the denominator. So all are said to be like fractions. Okay. Next is your unlike fractions. Fractions that have different denominators are called unlike fractions. So if a fraction have different denominator, then the fractions are said to be unlike fractions. For example, 3 upon 7, 2 upon 5, 4 upon 9, 1 upon 3, etc. Here you can see each of them having different denominators. So these fractions are said to be unlike fractions. Clear? Third is your unit fractions. A fraction that has 1 as a numerator is called a unit fraction. So if in a fraction they are having 1 as a numerator, so the fraction is said to be your unit fraction. For example, 1 upon 3, 1 upon 7, 1 upon 5, 1 upon 8, etc. Here you can see all of them having 1 as a numerator. So they all are said to be unit fractions. Fourth is your proper fractions. The fractions that have numerators smaller than the denominators are called the proper fractions. So in a fraction, whenever the numerator is smaller than the denominator, so it is called your proper fraction. Here you can see numerator is 1 and denominator is 3. So the numerator is smaller than the denominator, so this is a proper fraction. Here also the numerator is 2 and denominator is 5, and the numerator is smaller than the denominator, so this is called a proper fraction. Okay, next, fifth is your improper fraction. The fraction that have numerators greater than or equal to the denominators are called improper fractions. So if the numerator is greater than the denominator, then the fraction is called your improper fraction. Okay, for example, I have written 9/2. You can see here the numerator is greater than the denominator. Numerator is 9, denominator is 2, and 9 is greater than 2. So this fraction becomes your improper fraction. Same with your 5/3. Here 5 is greater than 3. It means the numerator is greater than the denominator. So the fraction is improper fraction. And last, sixth is your mixed fraction. When an improper fraction is written as a combination of a whole number and a proper fraction, it is called a mixed fraction or mixed number. So what is your mixed fraction? When an improper fraction, here I have taken an improper fraction 13/5. Why it is improper? Because the numerator is greater than the denominator. So I have taken fraction 13/5. And when I have written this 13/5 as 2 whole 3/5, it means you have written it, this improper fraction, as a combination of a whole number and a proper fraction. This 3/5 is a proper fraction. So this is known as your mixed fraction. Okay. One more is here, 17/5. Okay. So here it is an improper fraction, and again I have written this improper fraction as a combination of a whole number. This 3 is a whole and 2/5. This 2/5 is a proper fraction. So this is known as your mixed fraction. Next we are having equivalent fraction. Now equivalent means equal value. So the fractions which are equal in value are known as your equivalent fraction. Equivalent fractions are the fractions that have the same value or represent the same part of an object. Here, the value remains the same, but the form of the fraction changes. Now, we are going to understand from this example. Here, I have drawn 3 circles. Now, just come with your first circle. Here, I have divided this circle into 2 equal parts. And as you can see, I have shaded one part of it. So its fraction become 1/2. Clear? Now in your second part, I have divided the circle into 4 equal parts and I have shaded 2 parts of it. So the fractions become 2/4. And in the third part, I have divided the circle into 8 equal parts and I have shaded 4 part of it. So the fraction become 4/8. Now as you can see, in each of these 3 circles, only the half circle is shaded. Come to your first one, only the half circle is shaded. In second one, though I have divided into 4 equal parts and shaded 2 parts of it, but still you can see the half of the circle is shaded. Similarly, with the third one, I have divided into 8 equal parts and I have shaded the 4 parts, but the half of the circle is shaded. So though the form of the fraction is changing, as you can see here my fraction is 1/2, here 2/4, here 4/8, but the value of the fraction doesn't change, only half of the circle is shaded. So these kind of fraction, these 1/2, 2/4 and 4/8 are called equivalent fractions that are equivalent to 1/2. Okay, these all fractions are equivalent to 1/2. Why? Because only half of the circle is shaded. Next, we are having how to find the equivalent fractions. So, your first question is find the 3 equivalent fractions of 2/7. Now, when we have to find the equivalent fraction, what we do, we just multiply or divide both the numerator as well as the denominator of a fraction by the same number except your 0 and 1. So, I have done the multiplication, so I multiply 2/7 by 2. As I told you, except 0 and 1, so you will be starting with 2. So when I have multiplied my fraction by 2, I am getting 4 by 14. This is your first equivalent fraction. Okay, now for the second, you will take your fraction 2 by 7 and multiply it with 3. And you have to multiply both the numerator as well as the denominator with the same number for finding the equivalent fraction. So 2 3s are 6 and 7 3s are 21. Okay, this is your second equivalent fraction. And for the third one, I multiply the fraction 2 by 7 by 4. So when I have done the multiplication, it's 2 4s are 8 and 7 4s are 28. So the three equivalent fractions of 2 by 7 are 4 by 14, 6 by 21 and 8 by 28. Okay, so children, take care and thank you.